Well, she's the daughter of Judy Garland and the sister of Liza Minnelli, and she starred in productions like Guys and Dolls as well as Grease 2. Yes, Lorna Luft has showbiz in her DNA. In this exclusive interview, she opens up to Craig Bennett about her battles with cancer, growing up in a famous family, and maintaining her mother's amazing legacy.
Birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh why can't I?
It is the unforgettable song from the unforgettable songstress. Judy Garland was a once-in-a-lifetime talent, responsible for some incredible magic moments on the silver screen. And her ongoing legacy is remembered through her three children. There's Liza with a Z, with Judy's husband Vincent Minnelli.
Pardon yourself. Well, it's
Joey and Lorna, with third husband yourself. Sydney Love. And with a family tree like that, it's little wonder Lorna Love went into the family business to become a much loved and hugely talented showbiz sensation.
Thursday, April, August.
I think that you are a product of where you come from. For me, it was my normal. I didn't know anything else. If you come from a family of lawyers, you're gonna be a lawyer. I don't think I did anything unusual. I went into the family business.
They heard the breeze.
For Lorna, growing up surrounded by some of the biggest names in the biz wasn't anything unusual.
It wasn't all of a sudden movie stars were coming over. Everybody was a movie star. But I didn't know that. I just knew that they were friends of my parents. So I didn't think anything of Frank Sinatra or Humphrey Bogart or Dean Martin or Sammy Davis or any of them. They were my Uncle Frank, my uncle, you know, that's who they were.
Clang, clang, clang went the trolley. Ding, ding, ding went the bell.
Judy Garland's life has been endlessly described as tragic, a term Lorna doesn't agree with. Instead, she calls her a victim.
I do think that my mother was a victim of the studio system.
And the day.
And yes, but it also gave her the ability to channel her talent to all of us. It was a real double-edged sword. The highs were incredibly high. The lows were, and I say this in my book, were devastating. I learned about the disease of addiction, and that was a part of the whole story. It wasn't just the story.
I tell you what I found heartbreaking reading your book was the fact that you, even as a teenager, tried so hard to help your mum.
Mm-hmm.
And you'd find pills.
You know, I think that that's not unusual, because now we know it is a family disease, and it is a disease.
But you were so savvy because you'd open your mum's pills and put sugar in there.
Well, yeah, but I was taught how to do that by my dad. I was taught how to do that. And it wasn't unusual, because when you have a parent who's teaching you how to take care of your other parent, that's what you do. You don't think there's anything odd about this. You don't think there's anything wrong, because it's like someone today saying to their kid, when daddy comes home and wants another beer, or mommy wants another glass of wine, maybe not. It's still going on.
Despite seeing her mum die from battles with addiction, Lorna herself fell victim to the curse.
I used to sit and be doing a lot of stuff at Studio 54 that we were all doing. We were doing cocaine, we were doing all sorts of things, and I'll never forget. Somebody came up to me and said, do you not think that maybe you're doing the same thing that your mom did? And I said, oh, no, 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 she had a problem. I only do it at night. I mean, okay, stupid. But in a sense, that's what we thought, that was for real, until I went to the Ford Center and I got help.
So what was the turning point for you? What was that moment where you said,
I wanted a baby. The hangovers were not going away. I really honestly was sick and tired of feeling sick and tired.
Stories of Judy's harrowing life on the Yellow Brick Road are legendary, but are they true?
My mom would embellish on stories that she knew would make an audience laugh. Did they happen? Maybe not. She was on the Jack Parr Show and she embellished on a story about the Munchkins being drunk.
Yeah. And they got smashed every night and they'd pick them up in butterfly nets.
And that didn't happen. My mom embellished on that story because it made people laugh. They would have never, ever risked their careers, their one chance to be in a film.
We represent the Lollipop Guild.
The Munchkins were auditioned from all over the world. In the film, their credit were the singer midgets.
We wish to welcome you to Munchkinland.
And that upset them.
If Mama was married, we'd live.
Over the years, the relationship between Lorna and her older sister, Liza Minnelli, has been somewhat strained.
Well,
like all families.
I mean, no, we're sisters, so, I mean, we're going to have different opinions on different things. I mean, my sister thought I was the biggest pain in the ass when I was 7 and she was 14, and I was.
I did read that Liza's husband, David Guest, kept you two apart for some totally weird reason.
Honey, I didn't know him.
You're probably lucky.
I was really lucky. I didn't know him, and he ain't with us anymore, and so I don't know. But my sister and I will always find our way back to one another.
No matter what comes
into
being.
No matter what
you.
Comes into being. And I think that's the way it is with all families. Again, our family is just a little strange because it's under a microscope.
I've been alive forever.
Lorna has battled cancer 3 times, and it was the support of her best friend, Barry Manilow, that she says saved her.
Barry called me, and I said, I can't do this. He said, you got to stop. You got to stop right now. I've got the guy. I've got the guy. And he is going to help you.
I write the songs that make the whole world sing.
You don't know what you're going to do when you get that diagnosis. You don't, because you don't wake up in the morning and say, I think I'm going to react this way. You think, I'm going to have a cup of coffee, I'm going to have a cup of tea, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, I'm going to get the kids ready, or I'm going to go for this, I'm going to this. You don't think, what am I going to do today when I hear I have cancer? You just don't think about it.
So how did you react?
I went out and just sat down in the street and thought, okay.
This song was from my mom's last movie.
Hear that bluebird up in a tree.
In recent times, you've toured the world singing songs that your mum made iconic.
If there was a tiny word in any song that had the word rainbow, I don't want anything to do with that, and I'd run for the hills. It wasn't until I was in near my 40s that I thought, I've really got to stop running.
Although Judy Garland is now somewhere over the rainbow, Lorna believes her mother is still communicating with her.
She is on my shoulder every single day.
Watching over you?
Watching over me.
Why, oh why, can I?
Video 10, we'll be right back.